Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back. In this video, I'll show you how to create scripts inside Unity. Scripts are basically programming files inside which we write game development programs and codes. So first, inside the assets folder, I will create a new folder. So I'll right click in the asset folder. I'll click on create. I'll click on folder. And I'll give this new folder a name of scripts. I will open the scripts folder. And inside this folder, I will create a new script. So I'll right click in this empty space. I'll click on create and then I will choose this option which says C#script. Now, the reason why I'm choosing C#script is because C# is an industry standard language for game development. Okay, so I'll select the C#script. I will give the script a name of move ball. Okay, so please make sure that the move ball is a single word. Now, as you can see, my script is created over here. Since I've selected the moveball script, you can see inside the inspector panel, the code that is written inside the moveball script is shown over here. You basically cannot edit the code from the inspector panel. For editing the code, you have to open your script. So I'll double click on the script and open it. As you can see, the script is open inside a new software called as MonoDevelop. The MonoDevelop software gets installed while installing Unity, so you do not have to install it separately. So as you can see, the moveball.cs, CS is the short form for C#. So the moveball.c# script or C#script is opened over here, and this is the sample code which comes by default when the script is first created. Inside the script, if you look at the first two lines, so on these two lines, using Unity Engine and using system.collection is written. So these two lines are basically like header files and they contain many interfaces and classes. Next, if you look on line number 4, then we have a class called MoveBall. And if you look very carefully, then the class name and the script name are exactly similar. That is, the script name is MoveBall and the class name is also MoveBall. So whenever you create a new C#script, the class name of that script will be exactly similar to the script name. Separated by a colon, as you can see, Mono behavior is written over here. Mono behavior is a predefined class in Unity and it contains some of the most important functions. If we go on Google and if I type functions in Mono behavior class, then as you can see, I have this first link over here, which is the scripting documentation of Mono behavior class. So I'll right click and open this. And as you can see, this is the MonoBehavior class and these are all the functions which are inside your MonoBehavior class. Okay, so I'll basically minimize this for the time being. Now, as you can see, on line number 7 and line number 12, we have two functions called as void start and void update. The void start and void update function are basically inside the MonoBehavior class and we are just using them inside the MoveBall class. So basically, the void start and void update function are defined inside the MonoBehavior class, but this MonoBehavior class is programmatically put inside the MoveBall class by separating both of them with a colon. And because the MonoBehavior class is inside the MoveBall class, these two functions of void start and void update, which are inside the MonoBehavior class, can now be used inside the MoveBall class as well. And in programming terms, this concept is called as inheritance. Now, if you're not familiar with inheritance, let me take a very simple example. So just assume if you have two classes, class A and class B. Class A is empty, but class B contains two functions, void start and void update. If you want class A to access the void start and void update function, then you can simply put class B inside class A. So now, since class B is inside class A will also have access to the void start and void update function. If we compare the sample code with our actual code, then class A is like the MoveBall class, which is basically empty, and class B is like the MonoBehavior class, which contains these two functions. Okay, so after explaining you inheritance in simple terms, let me explain you what these two functions stand for. So the void start function is an important function and this function executes at the start of your program. That is, this function will execute at the first frame of your program. Now, if you look at the void update function, which is on line number 12, then this update function keeps on executing every frame. Okay. Now, as I told you that these two functions are inside the MonoBehavior class, let us check the documentation for MonoBehavior class and let us see if these two functions exist inside that class or not. I'll first press Ctrl F and this time I will type a term called as start. Okay, so for start, as you can see, I have 6 results. And if I go down, so as you can see, I have this function called as start, which is inside the MonoBehavior class. And as you can see, just below the start function, I have this update function. So guys, that's it from this video. I hope from this video, you would have understood how to create a script in Unity. And I hope you would have also understood the basic code, which is written inside the MoveBall script. I hope you would have liked this video. This was a free video from my virtual reality course, which is available on Udemy. This course is currently priced at $200, but you can get it at a discounted price of just $10 by clicking on the link in the description. So, if you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more amazing videos like these. Thank you guys, and I'll see you in the next video.